Hey guys, it's Andrea with Sucs For You in Houston, Texas, and we're looking at my husband's big, beautiful Clerodendrum speciosissimum, Java Glorybower. We moved it to shade because it was starting to look really sad, and we were giving it more water. We're like, wow, this thing is really thirsty. What is going on? And there's a lot going on. There are mealybugs under the leaves. There's all this stippling, like it looks like something is sucking on them. And even on the top of the leaves, there's like visible aphids. I'm like, oh my gosh, what all is going on? So I got out my handy dandy USB microscope, and I'll link to that in the video description. And sure enough, like aphids of every size and shape. There's one that's a little older. There's a spider mite crawling along next to it. I think it's a two-spotted mite. I'm not terribly sure, but they kind of all act the same way as far as how they harm your plants. There's a spider mite on an aphid. That's a fatty. There's smaller ones around it. And they all pretty much feed on the plant the same way. They're sucking the life out of the plant, literally leaving sticky nectar honeydew. Their secretions are sweet, so that attracts sooty mold. It's not pretty, and you do not want this going on for too long, or else you're not going to be able to even look how small these are. They are so small you can't see this without some kind of assistance, like a magnifying glass or a microscope. These are all spider mites. And all the little dark spots you see is where they were sucking on them and secreting and doing their damage. So while it's basically impossible to see spider mites, you can see their webbing. If they've left any webs, if they've been there a while, they will create these sheet-style webbings. What you're seeing is not a real spider mite web. This is just a regular spider, but it's a good example of what you're looking for. The way we're going to start treating this plant is just with a soap and water solution. I'm going to spray under the leaves, on top of the leaves, all around, and let it sit for a while. And the reason why I'm just starting out with soap and water, this is just unscented clear dish soap and water, a pretty thick concentration. But a lot of insecticidal soaps and other things like neem oil in the heat, it doesn't even need to be like in full sun, but if it's hot outside like it is here and you start treating with like these oil-based, or even if they just have a little bit of oil treatments, it can really seriously cause a lot of damage to your plant. I've learned that the hard way and heard other people have the same issue. So this is a process that isn't going to be a one-time treatment. You're going to need to treat it over the course of maybe like every 2 or 3 days, because that way if any like eggs hatch or anything doesn't die and it tries to crawl back up, you're able to like interrupt the life cycles and be sure that you have, you know, gotten as much of them off as you can. And another thing is, you can't treat spider mites with the same like pesticides as you can like mealybugs. They're not an insect, they are an arachnid. And if you use a miticide or something that's going to kill arachnids, that's going to also kill all your other nice little spiders hanging out and trying to help in the garden. And I have a ton of those, and I would be really, really sad if I did anything to hurt them. So repeating this process until we get the all clear. I know you guys have seen me whip out my microscope in a lot of other videos, and I'm so happy that I got it. I do like recommend anytime someone hits me up for a consultation or orders like an Ask Andrea one-on-one to try and figure out what's going on with their plant. If it's not obvious like what the problem is and they can't see it, I'm like, please, please get this microscope. I know, you know, it's money, but you're also going to wind up spending who knows how much on different treatments or just losing that plant. And it's, you know, going to save you a lot of money and a lot of stress just by having this microscope handy. Even though this isn't a succulent, unfortunately, every pest that we have seen here would be delighted to feast on our succulent collections. But luckily there's some affordable technology available to help us see what's going on before the problem gets
too out of control. I hope this video helps you out and doesn't freak you out too much, because it's, you know, we don't want to know that all that's happening on our plants, but we do need to know, right? Thanks for watching.